What's good, Pulse team? Hope you all had a great weekend. Well, lately we've been talking about in the devotions, we've been talking about focusing on our relationship with parents, especially for you guys. And the reason we're focusing on that is because of the time we're living in, you're around your parents more, you're around your family more than ever, and that could be great for some, and that could also cause tension for others. So today we're gonna be talking about, you know, things that we need to tell our parents, especially in the times we're living. You know, there's a lot of good things that come out of what we're going through right now, and one of them is an opportunity to grow closer to our family members, or parents, or siblings, to learn to get along, to learn to love one another unconditionally. So, you know, hopefully during this time you're taking advantage of that, but maybe there's some of you that are struggling, so that's why we're talking about this. But, you know, a few years ago, when I became a youth speaker, I'm just thankful that, you know, I was able to travel all over the U.S. and other countries preaching the Word of God and sharing my testimony and story. Well, through that, you know, came opportunities of being in Christian, you know, doing interviews on Christian radio, even some secular radio shows, secular TV shows, and Christian programs, and even magazines. Well, this one network that booked me to come and share was a network my mom watched all the time. And of course, if it was another network, she would have still watched it. But I felt compelled to be honest with her and tell her some things that I was going to share about my childhood that she didn't know. My father has already passed away, so this is when my mom was alive. So I wanted to go tell her, and so I sat down with her and told her, "Hey, mom, you know I'm going to be on this program, sharing my testimony and story. And there's just things that the things that are going to come out that I feel more comfortable if I let you know ahead of time, because I'd rather have you hear it from me than hear it from other friends that have watched the show or hear it from the program yourself." She goes, "Mijito, you don't have to. You're an adult now. You're following the Lord. I don't need to know these things." I'm like, "I know, Mom, but just out of respect, I just want to share these things with you." So I shared all these things with her. Funny, though, is that she told me she already knew I did a lot of these things. There's some things that she didn't know, and she was grateful that I told her, but out of respect for her, I wanted her to hear it from me. So even as an adult, you know, it's important to tell things to your parents. Go to them for certain things. So that's what we're going to be talking about today. Now, in the book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 12 says this, "Honor your father and your mother, that your days may be long on the land which the Lord your God gives you." Colossians 3:20 tells us, "Children, obey your parents in all things, okay? For this is well-pleasing to the Lord." So the Bible tells us that when we obey our parents and we honor them, that is well-pleasing to the Lord. Not only is it well-pleasing to our parents, but it's also pleasing God our Father, our Lord, is bringing honor and glory to Him as it is to our parents. Now, honoring and obeying your parents results in respecting your parents. If you're not obeying your parents, you're not respecting them. Because if you're disobeying your parents, you're disrespecting your parents. But not only are you doing that to your parents, you're doing that to God. Because God is well pleased when we obey our parents and honor them. Now, to accomplish this, to be respectful to them and honor them, we have to learn how to communicate, okay? Communication is the key to any kind of healthy relationship. Not only with your parents, but with your friends, when you're dating, sometimes even with your pets, okay? Communication is so important. But great companies, great armies, great churches, great businesses, great sports teams, and even great homes all have one thing in common. And that one thing is that they have learned to communicate effectively with one another. Now, communication is not just about talking, okay? Communication is also listening, observing, taking inventory of things, studying, investigating, and finally talking to the other person that you're communicating with. Now, people who only learn how to talk aren't communicating. They're not good communicators. They're just spewing out things that sometimes offend people, or confuse people. So that's not a good communication, okay? To have good communication lines with your parents, here are three things you must tell your parents, okay? First one is this, tell them when you need help. Don't be afraid to ask them for help. Don't let your pride or arrogance get in the way or stubbornness. Ask them if you need help in school, especially with school being online. If you need help, ask them. If you need help in any relationship, you know, with friends, co-workers, or even in a dating situation, if you need help when it comes to a job you have or finding a job, please ask them. If you need help and guidance, go to them. Let your parents know. This is why God gave us parents. He gave us parents so parents can guide us and help us get through tough times in life and even through the good times in life. So that was number one. Number two, tell them when you've made a mistake. Take responsibility for your actions. Take responsibility for your mistakes. When you don't, that could be the worst thing ever. It might be easier, you know, at the time to cover up your mistakes, okay? But honesty is the best thing to do. Honesty is the best policy, all right? You know, but honesty will not only help you to not make this mistake again or repeat it, it'll also earn you big points with your parents when it comes to the trust factor, the trust quest. When you want your parents to trust you, Be honest, take responsibility for your actions. The worst thing you can do is when your parents call you out on something, you know you did something wrong, don't blame others, don't blame them. Take responsibility because it is so very important. Number three, tell your parents that you love them and that you appreciate them, okay? Yes, there's no such thing as perfect parents, but most parents, you know, have done their best to invest in your time, invest in their energy in you, you know, to invest money in you because they love you and they want the best for you. So let them know how much you love them. Even if they don't always, you know, show you the same love back, show them how much you love them, show much how much you care about them, appreciate them. So the three things here to tell your parents: tell them you need help, tell them when you made a mistake, and tell them you love them and appreciate them. That is so important. I'm gonna end with this. Parents are treated a lot like God, okay? Because you want to know they're out there and you want them to think well of you, but you don't really spend time with them and only talk to them when you need something. Hopefully that's not you. Hopefully you go to your parents all the time because you love them, not because you're trying to get something out of them. And that's sad because individuals who treat their parents that way only go to them when they need something. In most cases, treat God the same way. They only go to Him when they need something, and that's not a healthy relationship, my friends. All right, hopefully you enjoyed this. Hopefully this helped you and encourages you to trust your parents and go to them and show them that you love them. Well, you guys have a great week, and we'll see you all on Wednesday, all right? God bless. Bye.